Okay, Party People, this is Michele Lamberti speaking. Welcome to the new game of the day. Yeah, we are starting our series with the four openings, the closed openings. The last couple of videos, I showed you E4 openings, and we are moving on. And this game is going to be Ullmann against Poma. Ullmann was a very strong German player. He played in the 60s and 70s, where he was a world-class player. He was even preparing Kapo for the for his match, world championship match against Korchnoi. And he was a specialist in the French defense. And Poma was playing with black pieces. He was a strong Spanish grandmaster in the 60s. So, okay, let's look at the game. Ullmann opened with c4, c6, knight to f3, d5, d4, knight to f6, knight to c3, and here we are in the king's gambit. The declined is a Slav, and now here. Basically, we have the Mirana variation. After taking here and taking with the bishop on c4, we see the b5 push, and white plays bishop to d3. And the idea here of the Mirana variation is that you get open space. You don't get this cramped in positions that you sometimes get with the queen's gambit. Declined, your white bishop will not be cramped in, and you will get an attack going here with b5. And the idea is to play your bishop to your black bishop to b7, and then eyeing down here and playing c5, so that you get an open queen side. And that you get a lot of piece play. The problem is that it's it's a complex position, and your setup with black will not be very harmonic, and you will see it here. Okay, plays a standard a6 to reinforce b5, and white plays e4. So now, okay, he's going for the center, and black has to play c5 to open up. To avoid white closing him down in the center. And here white plays d5, the Reynolds variation. And here black plays e7. A better idea would be to play e5 and just to close the center down. And then the player to play e5 with the idea of playing bishop to d6 and closing here the center down. This would be okay. Okay, bishop to e7 is not a mistake. Okay, so both party castled, and we see bishop to c2 by white. He wants to get his diagonal, and he wants to play the queen to d3. And yeah, basically in this kind of formations, you are playing for a kingside attack. You are playing for the centralization of all your forces, you know, because this piece here is a little bit iffy, and you want to try to exploit this. And black opens up, he has to open up, and white plays e5, and we see knight to g4 again, attacking the pawn on e5. Now we see queen to d3. The idea is to provoke g6, otherwise you get mated. You have here this battery here. You have your pressure against d5, and the problem is that this piece is a little bit awkward placed. After h3, where do you go? And you are a little bit underdeveloped. So now white took on d5. You have to save your rook. He plays Poma played his rook to a7, and this is better for white. It's not winning, But it's easier to play, and yeah, black has to solve some problems. And he played queen bb6. I used to play the Meran with black, and one of the reasons I stopped was because, first of all, you don't really have a good square for your queen, and at the end of the day, all your pieces are discoordinated. Yeah, you somehow have to create an attack, otherwise your piece is just intolerable. And yeah, this. This game showed why I think this is. Black white plays queen to e4, attacking the knight on g4, and here black played bad move. He played f5, so he's weakening this diagonal to the king. And yeah, I mean f5 in this kind of position is always a little bit dangerous. Okay, we will look later at the variations. Again, he played the bad move f5. And now we see queen to e2. Black still has a problem what to do after h3. Can he save it or not? And here he plays his king to his queen to e6. Yeah, yeah, he wants to gang up on his pawn so that after h3 he can take here. But black white just played queen bishop to f4, reinforcing the pawn on e5, and now h3 is a problem. And here black played b7, the counter attack. Basically, this is your only hope in the Mirana variation, that you somehow get an attack going with the help of this this bishop. And okay, white could have played a lot of moves, but he played this spectacular looking move. He played his knight to d4. You cannot really take, because then comes bishop to b3, and you will lose your queen. So he gets the queen out of harm's way. But now comes this little sacrifice here. He plays his bishop to his knight to f4, f5, capturing. And the idea is that after you take, white takes on d7. You do not win this any of the piece. It may look like, but the problem is that black can play queen to c6, and now he's threatening mate. So you will lose this rook. But this was all calculated by Ullmann. He wanted to play rook to b7. And now, after the h3, let's look at this position for a little bit. All of black's pieces are discoordinated. This one here, this rear piece is out of the game. Your king is wide open compared to this king. Yeah, I mean, and all those pieces, they are not working together. And now, in contrast, like let's look at the white pieces. They're all coordinated, they're helping each other, and white owns the center. So here white is clearly better. And here Ullmann played e6, pawn e6, he wants to capture here, and black defended, playing rook to f6. Now we see this forced line, and basically now white has won a pawn, plus this really great pawn structure and the center, so white has everything. Black, he played a good move. He wants to get his pieces coordinated and all on the king side to attack. And yeah, white just plays rook d1. Black plays bishop f6. See, very good centralizing move. Knight to e4. And yeah, black goes for his only hope, which is a kingside attack, giving up another pawn. He attacks with rook to h5, and black counters. White counters with rook to d5. Now this piece is protected, and yeah, look at the position here. You have white pieces are creeping closer to the black king. Still very good coordinated, and black has basically no coordination at all. Now he goes for some coordination, and immediately he has a threat on d2. White plays g4. Not afraid of the things that may come, because yeah, white has many threats. He can play d6, rook to d7. He can play knight to e4, and then capturing on f6. So this position is completely hopeless for black. But okay, he goes for tricks and plays queen to h5. Cannot take, and this pawn here is hanging. But black's white position is that strong that he ignores these reds, and he plays knight to e4. Black captured on h3, and here he played he took on f6, capturing and yeah, giving a check, and here black resigned in a hopeless position. This is already a mate position. This is already mate in 6 according to the engine, and here black resigned. He has no tricks, and yeah, it's all going to lose. Let's look at the line. Okay, here after king h8 you have this this mate, but basically it's not really mate. Yeah, black just senselessly gives up all his pieces. Let's look at this one, which I think is more interesting. You play king f8, and then your rook keeps check. Only move. You give check with the knight on d5. You sacrifice your rook, playing d7. What is the alternative here? The engine wants to play this move. Why can I not? Okay, this is immediately made. Okay, so you have to play king to e8, and yeah, again, this is all here. This is a complete disaster. So it was right to give up from by black on that move. Again, we saw here a lot of seams. If you play the Mirana variation, it's a very complicated position. You have to be very good tactically as black if you want to play it. You have to basically look for counterplay anywhere that you find it. It reminds me a little bit of the Sicilian defense. If you play the Sicilian as black, you also have to know exactly what you are doing. And yeah, the Moran is similar, so I wouldn't recommend it for a beginner, especially because at the end of the day all your pieces will be discoordinated. So it's not a good beginner's opening. And yeah, I mean, look at the position. White is always coordinated, and black is always throwing his pieces around, trying to get some counterplay. Then you get this kind of brilliant scene. And yeah, I mean, here, yeah, look at the king. It's not really beautiful. Thank you very much. Bye bye.